Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. Come on, Temple Judea. Shabbat shalom. It's so nice to see you here. Those of you who can be here in person, we really love having you here. And some of you have not been here in 20 months or more, a number of you, and it's just so wonderful to have you here in the Kahal, in the building, in our sacred space, so that we can pray together. And those of you who are watching online, we're thrilled to have you online with us as well. I'm going to say a blessing for this day of Shabbat, as we begin. Look to this day, for it is life, the very life of life. In its brief course lie all the realities and verities of existence, the bliss of growth, the splendor of action, the glory of each day. For yesterday is but a dream, tomorrow is only a vision, but today, well lived, makes every yesterday a dream of happiness, and every tomorrow a vision of hope. We know that there is sadness in our congregation because Jody Rosenthal is no longer serving as our cantorial soloist. And we are grateful tonight to have both Jenny Snyder as our pianist, elevating our worship, as always, Jenny, thank you. And tonight we have Stefan playing on the violin, which really adds an even more beautiful musical element to our worship. So thank you both. As we join together in our worship tonight, in singing, in praying, in blessing and thanking God for this day and for our very lives, we go forth with Shabbat.
Shabbat shalom, everybody. We're going to start with a nigun. That's just a simple way of saying you just sing lie, lie, lie. It's pretty easy. Join me if you can.
Dr. Goldser, on your new grandbaby. It's true. We're kind of suckers for all the babies. We love seeing all those babies and multi-generational families together, even not babies in multi-generational families that are here together tonight. We especially are so full of joy because we have a simcha tonight in person, and that is a bar mitzvah tomorrow. So we'd like to invite forward Alisa Elliott, Sam and Miles Gelber to light our Shabbat candles. And if you would like to find a siddur below your seat, turn to page 120. They're going to come light our Shabbat candles.
ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kishanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu l'hadlik nel shel Shabbat.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kishanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu l'hadlik nel l'hadlik nel
It is truly a joy to watch as the young children in our community who start in preschool and then keep coming to Temple and grow up into nice young men in this case. It is so wonderful to be able to celebrate the Simchas. We're so happy for you guys. Mazel tov. And now we continue our service with singing. Please join us in Lechadodi, page 142.
We're going to start with what's called in klezmer music a doina. A doina is when an experienced soloist like Stefan Zeichner solos over a few chords.
Oh my God, I should have ordered the pitcher.
Shabbat, 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 Shabbat,
remain standing for the Chatzi Kaddish, page 144.
Yitkatav, Yitzkarash, Meiraba.
Amen.
Be'amadi vrahirutev, yamlich mahutei.
Be'chayechon of yomechon, uvayetho be'Yisrael. Bakala, bakala, uvizman karivimero.
Amen.
You remain standing for the Baruch Hu, the call to worship, page 146. We continue together on the top of page 149 in the English. Please join me. Praise to you, Adonai, our God, from whom the evening flows. Your wisdom sets the way on which time and season glide. Your breath guides the sail of the stars. Creator of the tide of time and light, you guide the current of day into night. As heaven spans to infinity, you set its course for eternity. Praise to you, Adonai, our God, from whom the evening flows. Baruch Ata Adonai, Hama'ariv, Aravim. As you taught Torah to those whose names I bear, teach me Torah too. Its mystery beckons, yet I struggle with its truth. You meant Torah for me. Did you mean the struggle for me too? Don't let me struggle alone. Help me to understand, to be wise, to listen, to know. Lead me into the mystery. Baruch Ata Adonai, Ohev Amo, Yisrael.
Oh,
Please be seated, except for Miles Gelber. Miles, will you please come lead us in the Ve'ahavta? If you'd like to join us, it's on page 154. Miles has been waiting at least his whole life, 14 years, to be doing this prayer just for you. So.
Ve'avta Adonai Eloheha b'chol levavcha uv'chol nashecha uv'chol ma'odecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anohi matzav ha'hayom al levavecha v'shinantam levaneha v'dibarta ba'am v'shivteha b'veteha uv'lechteha v'adere uv'shoch b'ha uv'kumeha Ukshar tam leot al yadeha v'hayu letotafot b'neineha uktav tam al mezuzot b'iteha uvishareha l'ma'an tizkeru v'asitem et hol mitzvotai v'hitem kedoshim l'elohehem ani Adonai Elohehem asher hotzeiti Ethem me'eretz Mitzrayim, lihiot lehem, lelohehim, ani Adonai Elohehem.
Great job. All right, so I have a question for you, Miles. You ready? I hear you're pretty good at tennis, is that right?
Yeah,
pretty good? Like so-so or pretty good?
I'm okay.
Okay, all right. So I also understand that Rabbi Fish has been taking some tennis lessons.
Great.
Is that right? So I'd like to, I'm just going to put an idea in your head that after the bar mitzvah, maybe you should challenge Rabbi Fish to a little tennis match. What do you think?
Okay.
I'm not sure why anybody's laughing, but I think it would be really fun. I think it's a good idea. I'll come watch. I'm not a tennis player, but I'll come watch. Anyway, Mazel Tov.
Thank you.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Like really excited?
Yes.
How long have you been waiting for this?
14 years.
14 years, I know. We're so excited for you and for your whole family who has been, you know, your family's been a part of Temple Judy for a really long time, and this is something that I think your whole family's been looking forward to for maybe even more than 14 years, I don't know, a really long time. So, mazel tov. Enjoy
thank
every
you.
Second, and thank you. We'll see you at the, we'll call you up at the end to lead some more blessings, okay?
Okay,
all
thank
right.
you.
Awesome. He's great. He's really great. Not just at the Ve'ahavta, but really great. We continue with our service on page 157. Please join me at the top of the page. Standing on the parted shores of history, we still believe what we were taught before ever we stood at Sinai's foot, that wherever we go, it is eternally Egypt, that there is a better place, a promised land, that the winding way to that promise passes through the wilderness, that there is no way to get from here to there except by joining hands, marching together. Now, before we start playing or singing, somebody asked me before the service, when do I know when I should get up and dance and things like that? And I said, you know, it's really whenever the Spirit moves you. It's when you feel that feeling. And I do want to point out that, you know, there are some people who, like, that Spirit, you know, just gets to them and they want to get up and dance, and that's great, no problem. I know our people who have been on Zoom for 2 years have been used to getting up and dancing, like, with no inhibitions. And I think you should feel, if you feel that Spirit move you, you get up and dance if you want. And if you don't, that's okay too. Hmm. All right, let's have some Micha
Mocha. And some Micha people Mocha. Might say that Craig Taubman's Micha Mocha is not the most danceable Micha Mocha. I think Temple Judea will show the world it has been wrong about this. You ready?
We'll see.
Divar. Thank you.
from our celebration of freedom to a prayer for rest and to wake up renewed every morning. We say the Hashkivenu, it's on page 160 and 161. Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be our shelter from life storms. Adonai, help us to walk with good companions, to live with hope in our hearts and eternity in our thoughts, that we may lie down in peace and rise up waiting to do your will. Together, Baruch Atah Adonai, Hapore Sukkot Shalom, Aleinu V'al Kol Amo Yisrael Ve'al Yerushalayim. We continue with a prayer for joy, Yismichu. It's on page 162. So bring that joy that you may, maybe you did feel this week, maybe you didn't feel this week, but try to find some joy, something to be happy about, whether it's something that just occurred to you right now, or maybe you really have to work to find it, or maybe it's very obvious and right in front of your face. We thank God for the Shabbat to rejoice with all of our blessings. Yismichu.
I wrote this one during the pandemic based on Balkan rhythm. So the Bulgarian women's choir, they were a big thing in the 90s. And so it's a little hard to feel, but you just have to clap on every beat like this. One, two, three, four, here we go. And Yismichu, and I never took a shomre, shomre, shabbat, the God.
Home are a little bit less inhibited, maybe. I don't know. It seems like maybe that's true. But we love having you on with us from home. We love having you here in person. On page 163, we are a people in whom the past endures, in whom the present is inconceivable without moments gone by. The Exodus lasted a moment enduring forever. What happened once upon a time happens all the time. If you're able, please rise and join us in the Amidah, page 164.
Adonai Sefatai Tiftach Ufi Yagita Ilatecha. Adonai, open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu ve'lohei avoteinu v'imoteinu Elohei Abraham, Elohei Yitzhak, Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rahab, Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol, Hagibor, Hanara, Elohon, Gomer HaSarah. zocher chasri avot v'imahot. Umevi gila libnei v'nei hem, lema'an shemo v'yahava. Melech ozer u'moshia u'magen, baruch atah Adonai, magen Avraham ve'ezrat Sara. Ata gibor le'olam Adonai, mechaye hakol atah, Rav Lehoshia, Mashiv HaRuach, Omri HaGashem, Mechakeh Haim Behesed, Mechayeh HaKol Berachamim Rabim, Samech Naflim Berafei Holim, Umatir Asurim, Umechayeh Emonato, Lishay Le'afa. Kedoshim hoyom haleluha selah Baruch atah Adonai HaKadosh.
Please be seated. And on page 173, disturb us, Adonai. Ruffle us from our complacency. Make us dissatisfied. Dissatisfied with the peace of ignorance, the quietude which arises from a shunning of the horror, the defeat, the bitterness, and the poverty, physical and spiritual, of humans. Shock us, Adonai. Deny to us the false Shabbat, which gives us the delusions of satisfaction amid a world of war and hatred. Wake us, O God, and shake us from the sweet and sad poignancies rendered by half-forgotten melodies and rubric prayers of yesteryears. Make us know that the border of the sanctuary is not the border of living, and the walls of your temples are not shelters from the winds of truth, justice, and reality. Disturb us, O God, and vex us. Let not your Shabbat be a day of torpor and slumber. Let it be a time to be stirred and spurred to action. Baruch atah Adonai, Mekadesh HaShabbat. Ritzei Adonai Eloheinu be'amcha Yisrael, utfilatam be'ahava tikabel, utchilo ratzon tamir avodat Yisrael amecha, baruch atah Adonai, she'orcha levadcha be'yirah na'avod. We come to a prayer for thanksgiving, and we say, modim anachnu lach. We thank you, O God, for each blessing in our lives. I realized this week that it was exactly 35 years ago that I became a bat mitzvah reading Chaye Sarah, this week's Torah portion. It's hard to believe for me that it's been 35 years since then, but it has. And I was thinking about the many, many blessings that I've had in those years, in all my years. And that's really what one of the things Shabbat gives us, the gifts that we have on Shabbat, to sit with our families, to sit with community, or at home, to sit and be, just be. That's what we do on Shabbat, just be. To give thanks, to pause, to recognize each one of our many, many blessings. So take the time, we're not going to share them tonight, but take the time to think about, not only tonight, but throughout this weekend, all of the many blessings in your life. As we say, modim anachnu lach, thank you, O God, for each one. Baruch atah Adonai hatov shimcha olcha na'eh lehodot. And we pray for that greatest gift, the greatest blessing of peace. We will be recognizing at the end of our service, when we say Kaddish, the memorial of the Tree of Life attack that happened, this being the anniversary this week. And we, as we pray for peace, we know that this is not yet a peaceful world. We pray that each one of us will be motivated to work towards less hatred, less anti-Semitism specifically, but less hatred of any kind, and bring more shalom into our troubled world with these words, Shalom Rav. Before we have a few moments for silent prayer, a few words about Chaye Sarah, this week's parsha, the life of Sarah, a poem written by Ruth Bryn. We have heard, as our ancestors heard, how Rebecca drew water from the well, how Isaac lingered in the field at twilight. When we hear the chanting of this story, we listen to the dimension of time that is forever Israel's. Sometimes when we lie awake at night, we hear the trains rumbling by, the cars passing, the airplanes overhead. We are listening to the vastness and the distance, the dimension of space that is America's. Twice blessed are we, O Lord our God, who may seek the freedom of space and the wisdom of time. Twice blessed are we, O Lord our God, and render thanks to you that we can hear the chanting of Israel and the night sounds of America. We take time for our own silent thoughts and prayers. May the one who brings peace to the heavens bring peace to all here on earth, as we say, amen. We take time now to think of our loved ones who are ill, those who are struggling, whether they be ill of body, mind, or spirit. We pray for them. We pray for their caregivers. We pray for all those who are going through recovery. And we say these names of these loved ones that we're thinking of, and you can also say the names of your own as we'll come around in a moment, and you can put them in the chat if you're online. We think of Mary Arnold, Hope Ellen Keller, Yifat Bat Yoram, Judy Brown, Darren Williams, Mauricio Lara, Sharon and Paul Weiner, Bennett Greenberg, Ronald Horwich, Alice Horwich, Isabel De La Huse, Marty Gitlitz, Sarah Spatzall, Natalie Keegan, Edwina Cherubin, Roberta Lowenstein, Marvin Gilman, Dorita Levenstein, Yoli Marlowe, Mariana Green, Greg Miller, Batya Batmanacha Mendel, Stephen Carlin, Jessica Hunter, Peter Stein, Aliza Pellia, Bat Avraham Visara, Yael David, Marsha Kropp, Karina Casanas, Brenda Tucci, Carol Schulkin, Steve Hertz, Shirley Harris, Kelly Henley, Rini Feingold, Mark Kaplan, Steve Winkler, Diane Arnkoff, Jack Langer, Ilana Miriam Barchava, Judith Greenberg-Friedman, Joe Botkin, Ivy Bolenstein, Ava Wilson, Joseph Rodriguez, Jenny Wasserstrom, Sarah Jackson, Jeff Clark, Noah Schwartz, Sandy Kramer, Vivian Witkoff, Naomi Ulster, Dana Pelletier, Michal Batsara, Gloria Fague, Valentina Ledichevsky, Sonia Horowitz, Nancy Pastroff, Kyle Gittleman, Caroline Miller, Josh Rosen, Erwin Fetter, Sonia Greenberg, Hazel Bernstein, Elaine Van David, Maria Jimeno, Eileen Danheiser, Barbara Dorman, Jesse Friedman, Josh Snyder, Bella Lopez, Dr. Herbert Mercado, Gloria Checkenau, Carl Pascual, Howard Israel, and Patty Campo. And also, if you'd like to say names of others you're thinking of, please rise as we come around to hear those names. We join together in the words of the Mishaberach as we pray for each one to find healing and strength. And we all say, amen.
Tonight we have a celebration of Shabbat, celebration of a bar mitzvah, celebration of Rabbi Fish getting whooped on a tennis court, apparently. It's exciting. I know where all of you stand. A celebration of a wedding. When the mother's clapping, you know it's Besheret. You know it's Besheret. I would love to invite up Amy and Leo for a special blessing on this joyous day of Shabbat. You rushed up here so fast, Leo. You were like, there's a blessing for us for the wedding. I'm there. You were going to walk down the aisle so fast. They're going to have to do it in slow-mo when they play back for you. How are you both feeling? When's the big day? Right there. Take that mic. I'll take this one.
Next Sunday, November 7th, is the big day.
Sunday, 1 week away, and everything is done, right? Leo, do you know? Do you know if anything is done? Amy, is everything done?
Pretty much.
Yes.
Like 90% there, yeah?
Nice, 90% there. Well, on behalf of Temple Judea, certainly your clergy and your friends and family here, we are over the moon. I actually saw Mom practicing what would be the second dance over there, and it looked great. It looked fantastic. I want to give you this blessing. Stand with each other. Stand with each other. After this blessing, you don't kiss, though. I want to make that very clear, all right? Okay. If you want to take your, I see Mom's got a camera. Why don't you take your masks off? I'll be the one talking. There you go. Mekor Chaim, source of life. We ask your blessings for Amy and Leo. We pray that the sacred commitments of their wedding day will sustain them all the days of their lives. May the love that binds them be lasting, and let their hearts be filled with patience and understanding. May their home be a mikdash me'at, a sanctuary built on devotion to God, Torah, and Israel. May they be blessed with the health and courage as their love and friendship deepens through the years. We pray that they will enjoy good fortune and find shalom together. And let us all say, Amen. And we give you the priestly blessing, a special blessing. I'm going to ask if my senior rabbi will come forward and help us with this priestly Kohanim blessing.
Yivarechecha Adonai veYishmerecha. Yair Adonai panav elecha vichunecha. Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom. Ken yehi ratzon.
May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May you always reflect back to that one day at school where you guys met and think about all the cherished memories that you have. May you be blessed with good health, with family, and the greatest blessing of all, of shalom, of peace. And we all say, Mazel Tov!
Are on Zoom. We're looking for you to highlight
that.
We see you.
Mazel tov! Oh my God.
And that was some great dancing in here in this congregation.
Yeah, can we do it after services? After service. We got a sermon, we got services. We'll do photos in a second. Wow. I need a sermon. There it is. Okay. Michal Oshman, author of What Would You Do If You Weren't Afraid? One of the three books I'm currently involved with right now, really has me thinking. In her maybe third chapter, titled Replace Fear with Purpose, begins with the story taken from Viktor Frankl, from his book, Man's Search for Meaning. Frankl describes the terrible conditions he experienced during his time in Auschwitz and throughout other death camps. He describes the guards' dehumanizing treatment of the prisoners, the hard physical labor, the unsanitary conditions, and how, every so often, someone would choose to take their own life by running into the wire. That's the electrical fence that surrounded the camps. Now, one day, when one of Frankl's fellow prisoners told him that he was considering taking his own life, Frankl asked him, "Why do you want to kill yourself?" And the man said, "Because I no longer have anything to expect from life." Now, under the circumstances, the man's answers might be considered understandable. What could life possibly hold for him now that the world as he had known it has ceased to exist? Not to mention the loss of family, his home, his livelihood. But Frankl didn't see it this way, no. He looked at his friend and told him honestly, "It might be the case that you have nothing to expect from life, but isn't it conceivable that life expects something from you?" As individuals, we are facing difficult times, but as Jews, our days have been filled with anxiety and fear as we bear witness to more and more anti-Semitism occur around the world and even in our own country. Should we accept it and live in fear or replace it with purpose? Do we run away from the problem and hide, or do we muster up that courage and find purpose in helping eradicate the hate that exists? It is up to us. It is up to each one of us to help change that which is broken, possibly for ourselves, but more likely, really for the next generation. Our Jewish life expects this of us. And Viktor Frankl, sitting in Auschwitz, tried to express this to his friend, that life is more than just taking, it's about giving. And as Jews, we should focus our attention on giving the younger generation hope that they won't need to live in the shadows or in the fear of the Magen David, the Jewish star pendant that they wear around their neck, or the kippah that they wear around town on their head, or the mezuzah that hangs on their dorm rooms in college. According to the American Jewish Committee's Brian Siegel, I almost wanted to say my Brian Siegel, but he's not mine, regarding the State of Anti-Semitism in America report, which was released this week, stated that a quarter of more than 1,400 American Jews surveyed said that they have been a target of anti-Semitism in the last 12 months. Anti-Semitism is on the rise, and we must replace our fear with purpose. AJC CEO David Harris said that the report confirms that American Jews are deeply concerned about anti-Semitism in America, and many are limiting their behavior as a result. This should sadden us, outrage us, and move us to action. Remember how affected we were when, on October 27th, 2018, after hearing the terrible shooting at Tree of Life or La Simcha congregation, where 11 of our brothers and sisters were murdered for just being Jewish? What did we do? We stood up. We pledged funds. We lived proudly Jewish. But that happened in a different state. Jump ahead to the front page of the most Jewish news stories over the last 2 weeks, and we are reading about the importance of teaching the opposing narrative of the Shoah, as secretly recorded by a school administrator in the Carroll Independent School District in Southlake, Texas. The administrator, who was trying to tell her teachers that they must teach the other side of every story, misunderstood, misspoke, and missed the mark entirely. She has since backpedaled, apologized, even met with one of our colleagues, but her words tear into us, painfully, and maybe shockingly, or maybe not so surprisingly. We can't say that these incidents only happen in other places. They happen here, in our community, in our schools. Remarks are said between friends, which we overhear. They are said to us by those same friends, which I would argue are even more painful than the statements made by strangers or that which are tagged on walls. But tonight's sermon isn't about Texas or Pittsburgh or any other part of our country. It's about what's happening here, and we have work to do here in our community. So I would like to invite up Mia Barsky, a proud J-Plex volunteer for over 3 years here at Temple Judea, and a senior in high school. Her story is one that I think tragically we have all experienced or heard. Her story happens here in South Florida, in our own backyard. I want to thank you, Mia, for your bravery and strength in sharing your experience. These words are the very words that she typed and used for her college admission essay, and she will now be sharing them with us. Thank you so much, Mia.
Anyone here Jewish? One of the four boys asked from the opposite side of the roaring fire pit. Burn in the fire, another boy said. It was Easter Sunday in Colorado, where I was enjoying spring break with 10 of my friends from Miami. Together we skied, ate, laughed, and sang. The sting of these comments interrupted our celebration and caused me to question my own identity. This was not the first time I've experienced this type of hostility. Often at gatherings, people will announce that I am half Jewish, but I am so much more than just a dual faith girl attending a private Christian school. I am Mia Alexandra Barsky Fernandez Abril Klansky y Irastorza. I celebrate Hanukkah with latkes and Christmas with lechon and rice with black beans. I honor the high holidays and the holidays like Passover and move right into the Christian Bible with Easter. I go to a Christian school while volunteering at J-Plex on the weekends. It is seamless and exactly how my parents want to raise me. Why choose one when I can celebrate both? My mother has often said, my Catholic religion is just a continuation of your father's Judaism. And for me, it is that simple. No interruption, one big happy blend of two religions living within me in harmony. So when I encounter anti-Semitism, I am often caught off guard. Two boys from another school once told me I should have burned in an oven, and another girl said I should return to Auschwitz. Despite the insults, I do not believe my peers are innately bad. I have seen them demonstrate acts of kindness, participating in numerous school clubs, and devoting their time to helping underserved students by tutoring and organizing events. On the other hand, I have learned that sometimes those who are generally tolerant and compassionate can also be insensitive and hurtful. And these hurtful remarks, not only shown to me, but to all Jews, are painful, and not only to the Jewish half of me, but to the whole of me. My reasoning is that the anti-Semitism I've experienced is due to ignorance and fear, not hatred. For example, my hometown is a bubble, so culturally similar that it limits many of my peers from being open to other beliefs and cultures. Some of my friends simply assume that everyone they interact with shares their cultural and religious perspectives, mainly Catholicism. When they encounter someone who is even the slightest bit different, they can't help but target them. It is as if they do not know what to do in uncharted territory, like attending a dinner with multiple fork options and only knowing how to use one. This, I think, is what prompts them to be hurtful. Still, my friends and peers have been mostly kind and supportive. So rather than hurt them, I have chosen to show them their prejudices are wrong. I listen when they need a friend, and I give them advice when they need another perspective. Most importantly, I never prejudge them. I am Catholic and Jewish, or as my friends like to call me, a cashew. People think that the two are on opposite sides of the spectrum. However, this has not been my experience. I am like every other young adult. I go to baseball games and parties, and I love pizza and ice cream. Practicing both religions has helped me realize there are more similarities than differences between Catholicism and Judaism. Both inspire this cashew to long for a world where more people are open and inclusive. My personal experiences with religious prejudice have not made me bitter. Instead, they have inspired me to be an example of tolerance, understanding, and kindness. As I learned from the founders of the Society of the Sacred Heart, St. Madeleine and Sophie, your example, even more than your words, will be an eloquent lesson to the world. Or as Hillel would say, that which is hateful to you, do not do unto others. I pray and hope that one day future college candidates will not have to write of personal statements expressing the pain of being teased or tormented, hated or degraded because of their faith. Thank you.
Thank you, Mia. Replacing the fear that you may have had with purpose, may it only drive you to study up on your two shared faiths, find strength, and correct those wrongs when you hear it and when you see it. It's difficult, but each one of us becomes your partner, hopefully so we can establish a world that is more understanding, more loving, and more accepting. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Mia. And now I'd like to invite up to share some words, Billy Martin.
I don't know if I would have volunteered to do this if I had to follow, knew I had to follow her. Yeah, it's amazing. Shabbat shalom. It's always a joy to see all of you here and those of you on Zoom. And please know, however you want to attend and be part of the community, we welcome you. I'm Billy Martin, a member of the Board of Trustees at Temple of Judea. And I want to thank Alyssa, Elliot, Samuel, and Miles for lighting the Shabbat candles, and who will also be doing the Kiddush and Motzi in a few minutes. And Mazel Tov to Miles on his Bar Mitzvah, and to Amy and the Kaplowitzes on the Ufruf. If you haven't already done so, please be part once again of our strong Jewish community by renewing your membership for the coming years at judeagables.org. Your commitment to our sacred community helps deepen Judaism for generations to come. Join us tomorrow with our virtual minyan service at 9 a.m., followed by a virtual Torah study at 10. And be sure to read your weekly e-blasts or visit our website for Zoom links to all the activities that are going on here at this wonderful community. You're all welcome. Thank you, and Shabbat Shalom.
Please rise as we continue with our service with the Elenu found on page 586.
Bye. 3 years ago, a heavily armed man entered into the heart and soul of a Jewish community and opened fire, taking the lives of Joyce Feinberg, Richard Gottfried, Rose Malinger, Jerry Wabinowitz, Cecile and David Rosenthal, Bernice and Sylvan Simon, Daniel Stein, Melvin Wax, and Irving Younger, Zichrona Livracha. We add them to our community's yard site list on this day of Shabbat, as we also remember Benjamin W. Applebaum, Mayor Baskin, Rebecca Blackman, Bernard Blank, Andrea Cooper, Berna Friedman, Louis Hyman, Francis Hesser, Ruth Hockman, Abe Hollander, Rose Jad, Morton Kobitz, Jesse Cattell, Jules Jacob Lazarus, Max Minsky, Karen H. Pally, Albert W. Pally, Seymour Jules Simon, Frida Weinstein, Dorothy Gross Weiss, Israel A. Weiner, Irving Yellen. We remember at this time those who have passed away within the year: Esther Botlea, Sandy Fisher, Anthony Carmona, Flavia Silva, Cheryl Stern, Sally Weintraub, Robert Satinspiel, Ayala Anavim Bat Yafa, Peggy Selig Gordon, Susan Picard, Randy Robbins, Sophia Lambert, Carol Horowitz, Stephen Indianer, Francis Kolarak, Clifford M. Stein, Michael Pearl, Michael Tobin, Justice Gerald Kogan, Rabbi Solomon Schiff, Morris Levitt, Edward Lassoff, Evan Reed, Thelma Stein, Barry Hesser, Fred Diamond, Faye Pushkin Aronson, Vivian Machaber, Pearl Wald, Robert Siegel, Dr. Stanley Jacobs, Joan Rubenstein, Rosalind Winter, Murray Diamond, Fred Chekanow, David Dollinger, Robert Joseph Mezzi, Sue Katz, Natalie Ginsberg, Michael Stokes, Dr. Will Bleckman, Marsha Coven, and Sheila Resnick. Please rise if this Shabbat marks the first week of losing a loved one. If it's within the first 30 days of Shloshim, please rise. If it's within the first year, Shana, of losing a family member, friend, please rise. If this Shabbat marks the yard site of someone close to you, please rise. We rise as a congregation, as we remember all the lives of the Shoah who were taken. We rise to remember the lives of the soldiers in America who have fought for our freedoms and died, as well as all of the Israeli Defense Force soldiers who died fighting for our homeland, Eretz Yisrael, as we turn to page 598 to say the words of Kaddish Yatom. Yitkadal v'yitkadash shemei rabah, Be'ama divra chirute v'almich malchute, v'chayachon uv'yomechon uv'chaye dechol beit Yisrael, ba'agala uv'izman kariv ve'imru amen. Yehe shme rabba mevarach le'olam ulame almaya, yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase, v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shme dekudusha barichu, le'olam minko birchata v'shirata, Tush bechata v'nechemata, da amiram be'ama ve'imru, amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael ve'imru, amen. Ose shalom bimromav, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael ve'imru, amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us, to all Israel, and to the whole world, to which we all say, amen.
Shalom,
You must turn that fear into purpose. We can do that by pledging funds to organizations that combat anti-Semitism. We can write letters to newspapers voicing our concern when topics or issues come up that go against our values, our beliefs, or our safety. Each one of us must act, if not for ourselves, but for the future generations of Mias, so that way they don't have to write their college essays about experiences that challenged them, that made them feel unsafe in their own home environment or schools. That's up to each of us. Take the pledge, take the stand. Let's turn that fear into purpose and make a difference. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And now we have a closing song, which I know for a fact is going to highlight Stefan on your mini guitar.
His shoulder guitar.
We
call it a violin. Yeah. So this is Stefan Zeichner, and thank you so much for joining us tonight. It really is always a pleasure. We're going to end the way we started, with a nigun.
Elliot, Samuel, and Miles, you're leading Kiddush and Hamotzi. Come on down.
And online, show us your challah, please. Hold up those challah, the challot.
You can hold the other one, look at that. Teamwork. Are
you
ready?
Yeah.
We give thanks to to God for bread. Our voices rise in song together as our joyful prayer is said. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz.
Shabbat shalom, mazel tov.
Thank you.